So welcome, students. So in this question, given that you have an ellipse x square by a square plus y square by b square is equal to 1, whose eccentricity is e. Now, from a variable point on this ellipse, you have drawn a normal, which meets the x axis at q and the y axis at r. And if so, you are asked to find the locus of midpoint of qr. What is the locus of the midpoint of qr? So, how do we do this? Let us start with a variable point on the ellipse. So, how do we formalize the variable point on the ellipse? Let us think of the variation of point P in terms of theta. So, let P be a point theta. So, now what is the equation of normal at the point P? So, the equation of normal is Ax by cos theta minus By by sin theta is equal to A square minus B square. And what is the x-intercept and y-intercept of this? To get the x-intercept, put y is equal to 0. So, x-intercept is nothing but point Q is nothing but A square minus B square times cos theta by A comma 0. The y-intercept, which is the point R, is nothing but 0 comma. So, if you want the y-intercept, put x is equal to 0. So, minus of A square minus B square into sin theta by b. So, you have point q and r. Now, my locus point is the midpoint of qr. So, my h comma k, my locus point a h comma k is nothing but the midpoint of these two. That is a square minus b square times cos theta by 2a comma minus of a square minus b square into sin theta by 2b. So, x1 plus x2 by 2, y1 plus y2 by 2. Now, you are asked to find the locus of this. Again, it is straightforward. So, 2ah by a square minus b square is nothing but cos theta. So, 2ah by a square minus b square is equal to cos theta. 2bk minus 2bk by a square minus b square is equal to sin theta. So, now if you square it and add it, theta will be eliminated. So, 2ah by a square minus b square whole square plus 2bk by a square minus b square whole square is equal to 1. So, this is the condition on h comma k. Now, if you want the locus, substitute h with x, k with y. So, x square by a square minus b square by 4a square plus y square by a square minus b square by 4b square is equal to 1. So, this is the equation of the locus. So, now obviously this is an ellipse again, x square by some number plus y square by some number is equal to 1. What is the eccentricity of this ellipse? 1 minus b square by a square. 1 minus the smaller number by bigger number. So, obviously out of these two, for the original ellipse, we have assumed a is larger. So, for this ellipse, the number below y square is larger and the number below x square is smaller. So, this is something like a vertical ellipse, something like a vertical ellipse. So, what is the eccentricity of this? 1 minus smaller side square, smaller x square by bigger x square. So, eccentricity, the new eccentricity e dash is equal to 1 minus this by this. So, you get again b square by a square. So, if you do the ratio of this by this, everything will get cancelled and you get b square by a square again. So, which is same as e. That means, the locus that you get will also be an ellipse with the same eccentricity e. So, that is the answer to this question. Thank you.